Okay, so topic of today's discussion is MOS differential amplifier. So first, what is the differential amplifier? Differential amplifier is an electronic circuit which amplifies the difference of two input signals. For example, here if we see, there are two inputs, V2 and V1. So this differential amplifier will amplify difference of these two input signals. So in case of differential amplifier, normally we have two kind of signal components. First is a differential mode signal component, VID, which is difference of these two input signals. And second component is common mode signal component, which is average of these two signal components. So this first component, which is differential component, this is signal of interest, because in differential amplifiers, we want to do the processing of this particular kind of signal. While the second component, common mode component, that is normally a reference level, or it may be a noise level. And this is something which is not desired. Now the output of a differential amplifier is given something like this. You can see here this component corresponds to this differential mode component, and this part corresponds to this common mode part, right? And this AD and ACM, what they are? AD is differential gain and CM is common mode gain. So what we want in differential amplifier is that this differential gain should be as high as possible, so that some value corresponding to this part, and this part we want to suppress, because this is something in which we are not interested, it's not desired. So in order to achieve this particular kind of job, we have a performance parameter in case of differential amplifiers, and this parameter is common mode rejection ratio. It is CMRR. This is actually a differential to common mode power gain ratio, and it is given by this formula. You can see. So the high CMRR means this differential gain is very high, and if this differential gain is very high, it means this component will dominate at the output, and this common mode gain should be as low as possible, because we want to suppress that part. Ideally, the value of CMRR is infinite. It means common mode gain of difference amplifier should be zero. Or practically, what happens? The differential mode gain is as high as possible, and common mode gain is as low as possible. So practically, we prefer a differential amplifier in which the CMRR is as high as possible. Now, what are the advantages of differential amplifier? The main advantage of differential amplifier is that it rejects circuit noise and power supply noise. So whatever is the source of noise, that noise may come from ambient, it may be generated from the circuit itself, or it may be present at the input signals. So whatever is the source of these noises will affect both input signal or both output signals equally. But since in these amplifiers we take the difference of these two outputs, so the effect of noise will be cancelled out. So this is the main advantage of differential amplifiers. Not only noise, but even if there is a power supply ripple, that also is cancelled out. Okay, so these are the topics which we are going to cover in today's lecture. So the first is implementation of differential amplifier circuit, then signals which are present in differential amplifiers. We will discuss common mode of operation, then we will discuss differential operation, we will do small signal analysis of differential amplifiers, we will discuss this half circuit concept. It's very interesting concept for differential amplifiers, and it's very useful also. We will see single ended output also. Normally in differential amplifier we are interested in differential output, but in some cases single-ended output is also very important. Then we will do the calculation of transconductance, because transconductance decides the gain of any amplifier. Finally, we will summarize our discussion. So first point is implementation of MOS differential amplifier. So the MOS differential amplifier is implemented something like this. You can see here in this circuit what we have taken. We have taken two matched MOS transistors. Remember, it's very important, matched MOS transistors. So these Q1 and Q2, these MOS devices are there, and they are perfectly matched. Matched means they should be fabricated using same technology. It means we will get MOS devices with same K prime, same oxide capacitance per unit area and same mobility. This threshold voltage should also be same for both these devices, and not only these, their dimensions W and L, these dimensions should also be same. And all these things are not difficult to achieve because differential amplifiers are normally part of integrated circuit. And in integrated circuit, all devices are fabricated on the same piece of silicon, and the fabrication is done in the batch mode, means the same processing is carried out on the all devices. That's why it is very easy to implement or to achieve this particular target, like matched MOS transistors. The another important thing is that the two branches in the circuit, this branch and this branch, these two branches or these two sides of the circuits, they should be arranged symmetrically. It means the load resistance, this resistance and this resistance, these two should be exactly same. The source terminals joined together, you see source of this device and source of this device, they are connected together, and equal gate bias. So this gate source voltage for this device and gate source voltage for this device, they are exactly same. But remember this zero signal, so they are same in case of zero signal condition, because normally when we use this differential amplifier, we apply some input signal, at that time voltage here and here, they may not be same, they may be different. But when we say zero signal, means in the biasing condition, in zero signal condition, when no AC signal is applied, at that time this gate voltage here and gate voltage here, or you can say gate source voltage of this device, they are exactly same. Another important point here is the devices are biased using a constant current source. Normally biasing of this circuit is achieved with the help of gate source voltage in case of amplifiers using a single device. So that happens, that this biasing is achieved with the help of gate voltage, but here in this circuit this biasing is achieved with the help of this constant current source. Now this constant current source is ISS, and since they are symmetrical branches and these devices are also matched devices, so current in these two branches will remain same. And we can say that the sum of these two currents is equal to ISS, or another word we can say that this ISS is equally divided in these two branches. The next point is that field effect transistors should not enter into ohmic region of operation. We prefer that during amplification, in all input conditions, the devices are always in saturation region. So now we know how to implement a MOS based differential amplifier circuit. Now next step is to see signals which are present in case of a differential amplifier. Now first we will talk about input signals. We have two input signals. So one input is applied to one input terminal, second signal is applied to second input terminal. But in case of differential amplifiers, we are not interested in these kind of individual inputs. We are interested in differential input signal. So that differential input signal is used like this. So first we find out differential input signal, then we split it into two parts. So see, one part of this differential input signal is applied to one input, and the second part is applied to another input, right, like this. And these splitted differential input signals are superimposed on a common mode signal if present in the circuit. So in total we can say that the input signals are written like this. This is first input signal, so it is a common mode input signal plus this superimposed input signal, differential input signal. The second input component is given like this, but this common mode signal is not always present into the circuit, so most of the time we deal with this situation where we have only differential input signals. Now let's talk about the output signals. So in case of differential amplifier, you see it's like this. So two kind of outputs are normally discussed. So one is individual outputs. Individual outputs means the output voltage at this node and output voltage at this node. So if you talk about individual outputs, so these output voltages are expressed like this. So VD1 means this drain voltage of first device, and this voltage is VDD minus whatever voltage drop occur here, and it is written as VDD minus ID1 into RD1. ID1 is current in this branch. The same way we write equation for drain current at drain voltage at this particular node. But mostly in differential amplifiers, we are interested in differential output. So differential voltage output is written like this. So you see VOD. So it is defined as VD minus VD2. So this voltage minus this voltage. So you can see that here we are measuring this voltage with reference to this voltage. So you can say with respect to this voltage. Most of the time voltages in amplifiers are measured at this point with respect to ground. But here in differential amplifier, this measurement is with respect to another voltage level, right? So sometimes it is necessary to use a differential current also. So differential current is difference of drain current in this branch minus minus current in this branch, right? So the most important parameter in a differential amplifier is voltage gain, because amplifiers are designed to achieve some voltage gain. So the voltage gain expression in case of differential amplifier is something like this. So the differential D denote for differential gain, and it is a ratio of differential output voltage to differential input voltage. You see, the output voltage which is taken, that is a differential output voltage, and input voltage that is taken, that is also differential input voltage. And it can be expressed like this also. Differential output voltage means difference of these two outputs. So we are subtracting from this voltage, we are subtracting this voltage. Means we are measuring this voltage with respect to this voltage. And this is very important thing, because amplifier means gain, and that gain is calculated using this formula. Now we move to the next point, common mode operation of a differential amplifier. Common mode operation. So as name suggests, we are applying a common signal. So for example, this amplifier is there. So what we do, we consider this case that two gate terminals are joined together, and they are connected to a common mode signal, right? So here in this figure, if we see, they are not joined together, but you see the common signal is applied to both. This is VCM and this is VCM. Same signal is applied to both terminals. So it is like equivalent to like joined together. So if this kind of situation is occurring, so we can say that the VG1 gate voltage of this device is equal to gate voltage of this device. And it is effectively equal to the common mode voltage which we are applying there. So in other words, we can say that differential voltage is zero, because the gate voltage of both the devices are same. So differential voltage is zero, right? Now in this situation, current ISS that will equally divided in these two branches, right? Because gate voltages are same, so their currents in these branches will also be same. So this ISS current is divided equally in both branches, and ID1 is equal to ID2, and it is equal to ISS by 2. So for this same current, if we calculate voltage here, right, the voltage at this node VD1 drain of first device, that will be equal to voltage at drain of the second device. So we can say that VD1 is equal to VD2, and how much is this voltage? This is VDD minus the ID into RD, and I here is ISS by 2. So VDD minus voltage drop across this resistance, and that will give you the voltage at this node, right? So VD1 is equal to VD2. In this situation, if you find differential voltage, differential output voltage is zero. And so if you calculate voltage gain, you see it is written as A denote for voltage gain. CM means common mode. When the both input voltages are same, they are connected to same signal. So the gain is differential output voltage, which is zero here. So whatever is the input signal now doesn't matter, common mode signal doesn't matter, because differential output is zero, so gain is zero. So main conclusion of all this discussion is that this output voltage doesn't respond to common signal in this amplifier. So when we are applying a common mode voltage, so the gain is zero, right? We are not getting anything useful at the output. Now we have to see what is the minimum common mode output voltage. So what it is? So you have seen this circuit for common mode, the signal, the common mode signal is applied to both inputs. So now corresponding to these inputs, there is a current here, and this current is equally divided in these two branches, and here we get VDD, and this VDD is VDD minus voltage drop here. So what we have to find out, we have to find out what should be that minimum voltage here, right, for safe operation of the differential amplifier. So you can see the voltage at this point, that is given by this, because voltage is same in both branches, and this voltage is given by this. So what we want to do, we have to maintain that this Q1 and Q2, it is mentioned Q1 and Q2 here, it's by mistake M1 and M2. Anyway, both these devices should be in saturation. And for ensuring this, what we have to ensure? Drain source voltage of this device should be equal to or greater than gate source voltage of this device. So you remember this condition. So if it happens, only then this device will be in the saturation. So that condition we can write like this. So this is voltage at this node, and this is voltage here. So in fact, it should be drain source voltage. Drain source voltage means drain voltage minus source voltage. So we should, this is drain voltage, so we should subtract Vs from here. Vs is source voltage, right? This is Vs, right? Source voltage is here, and this here also, it should be Vgs minus Vs, so this minus Vs source voltage. But since source is coming in both sides, so this source will cancel, and that's why we are not considering it. So instead of writing Vds greater than Vgs minus Vt, so we are writing Vd greater than this Vz, right? So this condition we have to ensure. And how we can ensure it? So this voltage depends on this resistance for a given ISS. So if this resistance increases, voltage drop here will increase, and so the voltage which we get here, that will reduce. So that we have to avoid. So we have to control value of RD, because current in this branch is controlled by this. So if we want to control this voltage, we have to control this RD. So we have to decide what is the maximum value of RD which we can use in this circuit, so that voltage here doesn't go below a certain level. And the condition is this. So from this equation we can find out value of RD. So if we do some mathematical manipulation, so we can find out that RD should be less than this. You can see all these are constants, and for a given ISS we can find out what is the maximum value of RD, right? So but you know that in amplifiers we want to achieve high gain, and that is possible only if this RD is high. But this condition specifies the maximum limit of RD. So it means we are limiting the voltage gain, because we can't have very high value of RD. High value of RD is forcing this voltage to go below Vgs minus Vt, and if it happens, this device may go into the ohm region. So let's discuss one example here to understand this concept more clearly. So here you see the statement. A MOS differential pair is driven with the input common mode level of 1.6 volt. So this kind of circuit is there. So there is, you see, common mode signal is there, and both, if the signal is going to the both inputs. So input CM level is 1.6 V. So this is VCM, and ISS is given, VTH is given, and VDD is given, right? So we have to find out what is the maximum allowable load resistance in this case. So maximum value of RD we have to find out. So from the previous discussion, we know that this VD, the voltage at this, should be greater than VCM minus VTS. This we discussed in the previous slide, and we calculated the value of RD from this equation. The value of RD will be given by this expression. So if you put all these values there, VDD is 1.8 volt, VCM is given 1.6 volt, and VTH is 0.5. And ISS is given 0.5 milliampere. If you put all these values here, so it gives that RD should be less than 2.8 kilo ohm. So we cannot use RD more than this. So if you want to achieve higher gain, and if higher gain gives us a value of RD more than this, so we can't use it, right? So that way we can find out what is the maximum value of RD which we can use in the circuit. Okay, so we covered common mode operation. So now it is time to go for differential operation. Okay, now differential operation means, now VID is applied to differential amplifier and it is not zero. In earlier case when we were discussing common mode operation, VID was zero because both inputs were same. But here in differential mode, VID is not zero. And let's assume in the beginning that if it is not zero, it's positive, right? It may be positive or maybe negative, but let's assume it's positive. And it's positive means this is VGS minus VGS2. And if it is positive, it means this is high as compared to this. Only then we get positive value. And yes, so VGS1 should be greater than VGS2. Only then it is positive. So how we achieve it? So in the circuit, you see, it's implemented like this. So what we have done? So in order to ensure this condition, so this differential voltage, entire differential voltage is considered to be applied to this input terminal. So and this second input terminal is grounded. So it, and it's positive. So it ensures that in every situation and for every value of this, this is either equal to zero or it's more than zero. So we want to ensure this condition that VID is positive, right? Now, if it is happening, so surely ID1 is greater than ID2 because this is grounded and here we are applying some positive signal. So the current in this branch will increase, right? And current definitely in this branch is going to decrease. So the variation of current in these two branches is plotted here. So here we are showing differential input voltage. And so when this differential input voltage is zero, means both inputs are same. At that time, current here is ISS by 2, because when both inputs are same, then the current ISS is equally divided in these two branches and it is equal to ISS by 2. But when we are forcing this situation that we difference of these two inputs is positive and VGS1 is higher than this, then the current in this branch will increase. You see, this ID1 is increasing. It's increasing. And as ID1 is increasing, so ID2 will decrease because total current is constant. So that decrease in ID is shown here in this graph. Okay. So ID1 is increasing, ID2 is increasing as we are increasing the differential input voltage. But see, at every point, these two currents, if you add them together, that sum will come equal to ISS, right? Now the variation of corresponding output voltage is shown here. So if input voltage is increasing, this input is increasing, this current is increasing. So if this current is increasing, voltage drop here is increasing and voltage here is decreasing. That is shown here, you see. So when zero differential input signal was there, at that time voltage at both these nodes, this node and this node, was same and it was given by this expression because current in both branches was ISS by 2. And when this differential input voltage is increasing in positive direction, you see ID1 is increasing. So ID1 is increasing, so voltage here is decreasing. You see VD1 is decreasing. And if VD1 is decreasing, VD2 is increasing because current in this branch is decreasing. ID2 is decreasing here, you see. But you see, when this differential input voltage increase beyond a limit, so you see this current ID1 becomes equal to ISS. And if it happens, then ID2 becomes equal to zero, means all the current supplied by this is transferred to this branch and here current is zero, right? And if it happens, here the voltage is VDD. So this voltage is going VDD and this voltage is going to the minimum possible, minimum value here, right? So, and beyond this, neither there is change in current nor there is change in any voltage. So it means this differential amplifier is responding to differential input signal within a limited range. So from here to here only, this much range is there for which this differential input signal is responding, right? Something here, up to here only, right? This. Now similar kind of analysis we can do if we consider this differential input signal as negative. In that case, VGS2 will be more and this will be less. Then we will shift this differential input signal here and then this variation will be towards this side, right? But in this case also, we will reach to a situation when this ID2 reaches to a maximum and ID1 goes to zero, right? So we need to find out this range of input voltages, differential input voltages for which this differential amplifier is responding. So here this is the highest differential input voltage which we can apply to differential amplifier that we need to find out, right? Now suppose this is differential amplifier and we are applying some differential input signal here. You can see here it is applied here and this is grounded, so definitely there is a differential signal here. Now the drain current in these two branches given by these equations, right? And our purpose, remember, here is to find out the highest differential input voltage, right? Now what happens? So when we are applying this highest differential input voltage, at that time the current here is increasing and this current is becoming equal to ISS. This is the maximum current which can flow here, right? And this, when this happens, at that time current here in this branch is zero, so ID2 is zero in this case, right? So we have to find out differential input voltage for this particular condition when current here is ISS and current here in this branch is zero. So for that purpose, first we need to find out differential input voltage, right? So the differential input voltage, that is VG1 minus VG2, or we can write it as VGS1 minus VGS2. So from these equations we will find out VGS1 and VGS2. So here in these equations, you see this part is this beta 1, and same thing here, this part is beta 2, right? So this is constant and it is represented as beta 2. So from these equations we can find out VGS1 and VGS2. So VGS1 is 2 into ID1 divided by beta 1, and same way the VT will also go there, right? So first we will remove this square power by taking square root both sides, and then this term will also go there. Same thing we will do here, but VT will be cancelled because we are finding out difference, and VT will be same in both these. VT will be here as well as here, so it will be cancelled. So what we will get, that differential input voltage is given by this part, 2 into ID by beta. So for both these parts it will be written something like this. Now when we are applying this highest differential input voltage for which this circuit is responding, at that time ID1 is this and I2 is this. So we have to put these values here in this equation. So this will be ISS, this will be ID2 0, and we have to find out that when this happens, at that time what is the maximum differential input voltage. So that will be given like this, because this is ISS and this is zero, so this will be cancelled, right, because of this reason, and this will be retained here and this ID1 will become ISS, like this. And we can write it like this also. So VOV, under root 2 VOV. What is this VOV? This VOV is overdrive voltage, and it is written something like this. Overdrive voltage is VGS1 minus VT. So we can find out this VGS1 minus VT from this side, right? And this VGS minus VT overdrive voltage, this is a overdrive voltage. So in order to find out this, this will go here, 2 ID1 by beta square root, right? Square root power 1 by 2, right? And 2 ID, so when this is happening, this 2 ID is actually our ISS. So whole current is going here, so it is ID time, 2 times ID, like this. So if you put 2 ID equal to ISS here, right? So this part, ISS by beta, 2 ISS by beta, and this is ISS here, right? So this is our VOV, and this 2 under root will stay here like this. So with the help of these two equations, if we solve this part, we will get this here, right? So this is the maximum differential input voltage for which we will see some change in the currents and output levels, And if we increase this differential input voltage beyond this, this drain current in this branch will stay at ISS, and here it will stay to 0, right? And the voltage here will stay at VDD, right? So in the same way, we can find out the differential input, maximum differential input voltage, for which current here is equal to ISS and current here is 0. So the differential input voltage for that case will come out, the magnitude will be same, only minus sign will be there. So after this discussion, we can say that in order to have some responsive differential amplifier, the differential input voltage should stay within this range, right? It's very important point. So we should always remember that the maximum differential input voltage is given by this, right, this parameter. So we can summarize this discussion that to steer the current completely to one side of pair, we need to apply a differential input signal, which can be expressed either as this, so, or this. So this is the maximum range of differential input voltage which we can apply, and that voltage can be calculated using this equation or using this equation. Now you see, this change in the current, output current, as a function of differential input voltage is plotted here. And up to this point, the current changes, and when beyond this point, this current reaches to this level. And this level, you see, it's 1. This is ratio. This is normalized current. And I is the maximum current. And 1 indicates that the ID becomes equal to maximum current. So this current here becomes maximum, this current becomes 0. So you see, this maximum voltage is indicated here. And this side also it is indicated. So here in this graph, this is 1.4. And here this side it is minus 1.4. Now this range of differential input voltages can be changed by changing VOV or by changing ISS and beta. So here you see in this graph, for different value of overdrive voltages, the graphs are plotted, and you can see, so this graph is for VOV 0.2 volt. So when 0.2 volt VOV was used, at that time the maximum range of input which we can apply was something like this. And when overdrive voltage is 0.4, at that time the maximum range of differential input voltage is more than 500 millivolt, right? So by increasing VOV, we are able to increase the range of differential input voltages which we can apply here. But remember, when we are increasing range of differential input voltage, slope of this graph is also changing. And what this graph is giving? Output current as a function of differential input voltage. So it means it's transconductance. And this slope indicates transconductance. So when we are increasing this overdrive voltage, the range of differential input voltage of course is increasing, but the slope is decreasing. It means transconductance is decreasing, and transconductance decides gain, right? So it means here, for this graph we will get less gain, and for this graph we will get more voltage gain. So we can conclude our discussion that higher differential input voltage limits the voltage gain. So if you increase the range of differential input voltages for a differential amplifier, its gain will decrease, which is evident from this decrease in slope of this graph. Now next point is small signal analysis, right? We will cover this. Now the small signal analysis is very important for any kind of electronic circuit, right? So the electronic circuits are given like this, and in the circuits we have two kind of voltages or currents, DC voltages and AC voltages, right? So the AC component is superimposed on the DC component, right? And it is very important to separate out this AC component, and that involves this small signal analysis. And it's very important because it helps us to find out many important performance parameters of electronic circuits. So first we write the instantaneous signal values. Instantaneous signal values considers or takes into account both components, AC component as well as DC component. So you see here, the drain current which is flowing here, that is mentioned like this. So this is DC component, zero signal current, and this component which is coming here, this component is AC component, right? It is present here because of differential input signal. And the current in the second branch is given like this. So in the same way, the voltages can also express the VD1, the output voltage here, and output voltage here, this is VD2. So that is VDD minus RD into ID, and the ID is this. So DC component plus AC component. So when we do small signal analysis, we have to separate out AC component and we have to ignore the DC values present into the circuit. For that, we have to draw equivalent circuit. So this is not full equivalent circuit. So only partial equivalent circuit you can see, we can say it, because the devices are kept intact. Only thing which we have done here is that the DC voltages are considered as short circuit. So they are shown as they are grounded like this, right? And the another change which we have done here is this part is ignored, right? And you see this part is ignored from here. Why we are ignoring it? Because this point behaves like a virtual ground point. Why? Because if we see the operation of the circuit is symmetrically designed on both sides of this point. So the current and voltage changes here and the changes here also, but this change is equal and opposite, right? And the voltages here are changing, but voltage at this point never changes. It always remains fixed. All the voltages above this point can be measured with respect to this. Normally voltages are measured with respect to ground, but here in this circuit, since this voltage is always constant for all ranges of input signals, this is always fixed. So all these voltages can be measured with respect to this point. So this point behaves like ground. This is not actual ground, but behaves like ground. So that's why we call it virtual ground. So anything below this point can be ignored, because that will not affect our AC analysis at least. So that way we can simplify the circuit. So, but still it's not full equivalent circuit, because the equivalent circuit of those devices is not inserted here. Now let's separate out AC components. You see here we have to consider only AC components, no DC component will be discussed here. So if we separate out AC component from this part, you see only AC component we have written, so this DC component will be cancelled, and same way here also we have kept only the AC component. And if we talk about the output voltages, so this is DC component, this also is DC component, this is AC component, so multiplied by RD. So this is coming here, so minus plus minus GM VID by 2 into RD. The same way we will write from here, we will get this. So if we find out differential output voltage, then we can find out gain also, and the gain is differential output voltage divided by differential input voltage. Differential output voltage is the difference of these two output voltages. We can calculate from here, right? Minus and this minus, so it will be added and this 2 will be cancelled, and what we get is something like this. GM will stay here, VID will cancel because of this, and we get only this. So this is equation of voltage gain, right? And the most of the time when we use amplifier circuit, so the equation of gain is something like this. But you see here the gain depends on GM and RD only, so this is not complete equation, because still it is not considering many effects which are present into the circuit. For example, many times we have seen that the voltage gain also depends on the output resistance of device. Output resistance means resistance offered by the drain source component, right? Drain source resistance of these devices. But that resistance is not coming into picture here, because still this equivalent circuit is not complete equivalent circuit. So if we use a complete equivalent circuit, then we expect that we will get here more accurate equation of voltage gain. So let's move to the more accurate or more complete equivalent circuit. So this is the equivalent circuit which we got in the previous discussion, in the previous slide. So this equivalent circuit have this virtual ground point here, and now we are going to the full equivalent circuit. So this point is grounded here, this is virtual ground point, and this device is replaced by its equivalent circuit. So this is the equivalent circuit of this MOS device, and this is the equivalent circuit of this second MOS device. You see, here on the input side, this is open circuit because no gate current is possible at this point. And here on the output side, we have constant current source, and this is RGS, which is R naught, which is drain source resistance of this Q1. Same way, this is drain source resistance of Q2, and the RD is here, and this part, you see, it's grounded. So when we use this circuit, you see, this is ground and this is ground, so this will come here and this resistance will be in parallel with this resistance, right? So these two resistances are in parallel, and here we are, they are connected to this current source. Now in the previous discussion, we have seen that there are some input signals and output signals also. We will consider these signals were there, we discussed in the previous slide. Now the signals which are present here in this equivalent circuit, that will be listed here. So the output voltage V01 here, so that output voltage we can find out using this current and this resistance. Now current here is this GM into VGS, gate source voltage, and this gate source voltage, you see here, the differential input signal is splitted, and half part of that differential input signal is applied here and another half is applied here. So if this input signal is applied, corresponding to this input signal, we can calculate how much current is there. That current is GM into half VD, because this is input voltage and this part is current, right? This part is current which is flowing here, and the voltage, if you want to find out the voltage, is, so if we use this closed loop here, so if this closed loop, so the voltage here will be current multiplied by this net resistance, and net resistance is parallel combination of this resistance and this resistance. This is parallel combination of this one. So this is current which is flowing here in this branch multiplied by this parallel combination of these two resistances. So that we will get voltage at this point, right? And if you talk about voltage here, this voltage here will be given by this part. So this is current here, that will be given GM into VGS2, and VGS2 is this, and then the parallel combination of these two resistances, right? Like this. And if you find out differential output voltage, that will be given like this. So this is minus, and now minus this, and they will be added, and this two will go because they will be added, and we will get finally this. And if you find out voltage gain, which is ratio of differential output voltage to differential input voltage, so we will put this value here, and then we will divide it by VID. So VID, this is actually VID, this is VID, right? So this VID and this VID will cancel each other, and finally what we get, this. So this is equation of differential voltage gain. So you see here, in the previous slide it was GM minus GM into RD, but now it is parallel combination of drain source resistance and this drain resistance. So this equation is more accurate equation for the voltage gain. But you see one similarity, if these resistive components are represented by their transconductance values, means for example this is G naught and this is GD, right? Transconductance values. Now these two transconductances are coming in parallel, so we have to express everything in terms of transconductance. So net transconductance will be sum of these two, G naught, this is G naught plus GD, right? And here we are using parallel combination of resistance, so parallel combination of resistance is inverse of total conductance. So this gain can be expressed something like this also. This GM will stay here, right? And this parallel combination of resistances is replaced by inverse of total transconductance, and total transconductance will be given as G naught plus G D, right? And of course negative sign is also there. So if you use this equation for voltage gain or this voltage of equation for voltage gain, you will get same result. And from here you can recall a similarity. So when we were discussing a inverting amplifier using MOS, that time also the equation of voltage gain was written in term of transconductances only, and it was something like this, right? Only transconductances are mentioned here. But remember, if you are using resistances, then it will be something like this. It's your choice how you want to solve the problem. So that way the small signal analysis part is over, right? So the next topic of discussion is this half circuit concept. So what it is and how it is useful in case of differential amplifiers. So we have seen that the circuit of differential amplifier look like this, and you see, so here what we have done, so we have taken the differential, so only, okay, so differential input voltage and half part of differential input voltage is applied to this and another half is applied here, and we can see that, okay, so there is a line of symmetry here. So this current source is replaced by this resistance because the current sources can be modeled using high resistance. So this is a line of symmetry. So if we go this side or we go this side, we see exactly same kind of circuit. So same values of resistances and devices are there. Now what happens? So because of this symmetry, so it's possible that this differential mode circuit is, where is pointer? Yeah. This differential mode circuit is possible to break into two identical half circuits, right? So one half circuit is this side and one half circuit is this side. So let's see this symmetry in more detail. Now the current about the symmetry line are equal in values and opposite sign. So when this differential input signal is applied, so we are talking only about the AC currents. So if the current here is increasing, current here is decreasing. So if current here is increasing by 2 milliampere, current here will decrease by same amount, that is 2 milliampere, right? In the same way, so the magnitude of change is same, but sign is opposite. In the same way, if voltage here is changing, so by say about 5.5 volt, so voltage here will also change by the same amount, but opposite sign. So suppose here voltage is increasing by 0.5 volt, and here voltage will decrease by 0.5 volt, right? So if this equal and opposite kind of changes are there, then at the symmetry line we can consider that the voltages here are zero, and that's why this point we are indicating as zero voltage here. So we have discussed in the previous slide the concept of virtual ground. This concept is almost same. Now because of symmetry it is happening, and here we can consider that it's zero voltage. And so if it happens, whatever is here on the bottom side, so that we can ignore, we need not to consider this part, and we can consider that this is ground, and that way we can represent this circuit something like this. So this is zero volt, we are considering it as ground. So the source of this is ground, source of this is ground. So this is a pair of half circuits, and we are trying to say that if we use this circuit for analysis, or if we convert it, or if we assume this circuit as a pair of two half circuits, it's the same thing. So for any kind of analysis, if we use this or if we use this, we are expected to get similar kind of result. So now in the next slide we are going to check whether it happens or not. Now first we will write down the equations for this circuit, so differential amplifier, and this side we will write equations for voltage and currents for this pair of two half circuits. So the output voltage at this node is given by this equation. We have seen it from our previous discussion. Voltage at the second node is given by this, Differential in output voltage we calculated, and it was something like this, and voltage gain was given by this, right? And this was voltage gain. Now see what happens in case of this pair of two half circuits. So this is a common source MOS amplifier, and this is also common source MOS amplifier. Now this voltage is input voltage is applied here, and for this input voltage, if you want to find out this output voltage, the output voltage will be given like this. So GM into input voltage, so that will give us current, and this current multiplied by this parallel combination of these two resistances. R0 is output resistance of this. So in case of common source amplifier, output voltage is normally given like this, and you see here minus sign is there because this kind of common source amplifier act as inverting amplifier. So if this is positive voltage, here we will get negative voltage, so that's why this minus sign is here. And this voltage was positive, and it is written here itself as a positive voltage. And for the second common source amplifier circuit, output voltage will be given by this equation, same equation. Only difference is there that here input is this negative input, right? So here this output will be negative, and here this output will be positive, because minus minus will become plus. So if you find out differential output voltage, VO1 minus VO2, so this is minus minus this, but this is plus, so plus minus minus it will become minus. And if we add, so this part is common, so this half and this half will be added, and we will get this. So you can solve it, and you will find this differential output voltage. And now voltage gain, which is ratio of differential output to differential input. So this is differential input, so this is I, right? So and here also this is I, right? So this is missing here, and this is also I, right? So this VID and VID, they will cancel each other, and what we get here is only this much. So this is voltage gain. So you can see, if we are using this complete differential amplifier circuit and we are analyzing this circuit, we are getting this voltage gain. And if we use, instead of this whole differential amplifier, we use a pair of two half circuit common source amplifier. This is common source amplifier, this is common source amplifier. So if we consider pair of these two half circuits and we do analysis on these circuits, here also we are getting same voltage gain. And that way we can say that this full differential amplifier and this pair of two half circuit, they are equivalent. So we can use either of these two for analysis. And from our experience, we know that common source amplifier is very easy to solve. So if we use pair of these two half circuits and then we apply it to find out differential output voltages, it will be more easy to do the analysis of the circuit. So this half circuit concept we have covered, and it's very useful in simplifying the analysis. Now the next point is the single-ended output. Single-ended output means we are taking output only at one end. Normally in case of differential amplifier, we have one output here and one output here, and we take the difference of these two. And we have seen in the previous slides that we are measuring this voltage with respect to this voltage. But in some situations, we take single output, right? And we are not taking any output from this side. But still, the input is a differential input, right? So differential input voltage is used, but output is not differential. So we call it single-ended output. It's single-ended output. It's taken at one end only. So now we will see what is the voltage gain in this kind of situation. And we have seen that instead of solving this circuit, we can use this half equivalent part and we can solve this. But since it is single ended, we are not going to use this output. We are going to consider only this output. So if we do analysis of this part, so you can see the input signal is still differential input signal, right? This is VID. So input here is applied to both. But when we are doing analysis, we are finding its differential input, and then we are applying half part here and half part here, and the rest of analysis we will do on the CLs, common source amplifiers. Now, but output, so this input is differential, so output signal is differential, so we have to so output signal is a single ended output, right? So we have to consider only one output, VO2, only this, right? And this only this, and this is discarded. So now if you want to find out voltage gain, so voltage gain here is written like this. So A for voltage gain, and this S is for single-ended. D means differential, so differential input and single-ended output. S for single-ended output, D for differential input. And it will be given by this formula. It's ratio of single-ended output to differential input. Only one output is considered here. This output is given by this. So if we solve it, so VID will be cancelled. So here these parts will remain. So GM by 2 and this. So this is the voltage gain for a single-ended output mode. And you see here, it's GM by 2. So in our previous discussion, when we were considering differential mode, we were taking output as a differential output, at that time there was GM here, but here now it's GM by 2. So this is interesting, and we have to think about it, why it happens, right? Now let's have a brief comparison of differential output mode and single-ended output mode. So voltage gain, you know, in any case is given by this. The voltage gain is GM into equivalent resistance, and GM is transconductance. So voltage gain is transconductance into net load resistance, and most of the time it is parallel combination of output resistance offered by device and RT, which is load resistance. So now let's compare differential output and single-ended output. So we will compare the voltage gains. So in case of differential output, voltage gain is given by this equation, and in case of single-ended output, voltage gain is given by this equation. So difference you see here, difference is here. Here it's GM, here it's GM by 2. So the transconductance, it's very important parameter. Now, if we see this difference, we can write it like this. So this transconductance, right? So this transconductance here, in case of differential input, is this. And this transconductance for this single-ended output is this, and it is like GM by 2, right? So the transconductance in case of differential output is given by GM only. So this is D here. D indicates that we are considering differential outputs. So GM is transconductance for differential output, that is equal to GM, and this transconductance for single-ended is given by this. It is indicated by S, single-ended output. So the transconductance for the single-ended output is given by GM by 2. Its transconductance here is half of differential output transconductance. So now let's calculate the GM. GM, you know, is given by this, or we can write it like this also. All this is like beta, right? And we have written ISS also, because 2 into ID, that is equal to ISS. So 2 into ID, that is ISS, and all this part is equal to beta, right? So transconductance will be given by this. So in case of differential output mode, this transconductance GMD is GM, and it is given by this, right? And in case of the single-ended output, this transconductance is GM by 2, and so GM we know is this, right? And we have put here this 4, so this is square root, so this 4 goes outside, so it is 2, right? So again, this transconductance, you see, it's half of this transconductance. It means if we are interested to find out high gain, so better it's go for differential output. But there are some situations where okay, so now next point is calculation of transconductance. So we have seen in the previous slide that transconductance is very important parameter and it decides the gain. Now we will move to the next step and we will see the more accurate way or more detailed way of finding out transconductance in case of differential amplifier. Now see, so we have seen that there are two different values of transconductances. For differential output we have a one value, for single ended output we have a different value. So first we will see how to find out value of transconductance for differential in differential out mode. You can see that the outputs are taken at both ends, so this is differential output. So if you want to find out transconductance for this, what we need? So we need a differential output current as a function of differential input voltage, that we have to find out. Or we need to find out some mathematical expression where differential input voltage, differential output currents, they are related to each other. So first we will write down the equations for output currents. So we have seen these equations many times. And now we will write equation for the differential input voltage. So already we have seen how to write this. So this is difference of gate source voltages of these two devices. And from here we can find out VGS1, that is 2 times ID divided by IB square root. VT will go that side, but since the VT is present, same VT is present in both terms, they will be cancelled and only this component, which is 2 ID by beta 1, it is present here. So only that part will be used. But we cannot use this equation to find out transconductance, because here of course we have differential input voltage, but we don't have a differential output current. Or you can say the currents which are present here, both currents are present here. So either we have only one current or we have differential output current. Only then we can use this equation to find out the transconductance. So how to solve this equation? So first we have to make this equation as equation with parameter 1 drain current and differential input voltage. So how we can do it? So we have to assume that the beta 1, beta 2, they are same, and it's bit equal to beta, it's wrong, it's like not here, right? So it's equal to beta. And the second assumption, it's not assumption, it's reality, this ISS is equal to ID1 plus ID2. So from this equation, we will find out ID1 as a function of ISS. So if you put ID1 here, then it will be ISS and ID2, these terms will be there. So then this equation will have one drain current and differential input voltage, right? But in order to solve it, what we have to do it? We have to form its quadratic on both sides, because square root is there, right? And during its solution, you will find that not only once, but you have to take square root 2 times. You will solve it with one square root for few steps, and then you will take square root again. So means many times you will do that kind of mathematical things, and finally you will get this kind of equation. So here you will have ID1 as a function of differential input voltage, right? So you can write these equations directly by writing this kind of statement, that is enough. But if you want to be sure how you got it, then you can solve it on paper, and finally you will get these two equations, right? So we have drain current, first drain current as a function of differential input voltage, then second drain current with the help of as a function of differential input voltages. Now you can find out differential output current, so by taking out difference of these two, and this will come out something like this. So this part will cancel, and this minus this, so they, it means they both will be added, and we will get something like this. Now in order to find out transconductance, you see this is differential output current as a function of differential input voltage, so we have to find the derivative of this differential output current as a function of differential input voltage. But this thing we have to do with this condition, that differential input voltage should be zero. So after finding out its derivative, then whatever terms are there with VID, so there we will put VID equal to 0, and then we will simplify it. So again I am writing direct results. So what we will get is something like this. right? So we can put, we can further simplify it. Beta values are entered here. Beta is k prime w by l. We can write it like this also, or if required, we can write it like this also, because this ISS is 2 time IT. So depending on the parameters available or depending on the situation, we can use any one form out of these three forms, right? So that way we get transconductance in case of differential output mode. You see D is there, this differential transconductance. Same way we can find out transconductance in case of single-ended output, differential input and single-ended output is there. A single-ended output means the output current, single-ended output current has to be expressed in term of differential input voltage. So again, the equations of current are written like this. Using same steps, we will solve and we will find out ID1 and ID2 as a function of VID, like this. But difference here is that instead of finding out differential output current, we use only one difference, one output current, because it's single-ended. So it is here. Okay, so it is connected to this node where ID2 is there, but actually we are differentiating it with respect to ID1. That doesn't matter. We will get almost same result because it is symmetrical circuit. So if we find derivative of this ID1 with respect to differential input voltage, single-ended current, output current as a function of differential input voltage, so we will get this value. We can express it like this by putting values of beta, or this ISS can be expressed as 2ID, so we will get this. Again, we have three different forms, so depending on the parameter available and depending on situation, we can use any one out of these three, right? So this is transconductance in case of single-ended output, differential input, single-ended output. So now it is time to summarize this lecture. So what we have covered here, we have seen differential amplifier circuit, MOS-based differential amplifier circuit, how it works. We have seen its equivalent circuit, and we also have seen that sometimes it is better to express this differential amplifier as a pair of two common source amplifiers, right? And the half part of differential input is applied here and another half is applied here. So if we use this kind of pair and we simplify it, it will become very easy to get the results of any kind of parameter or any kind of expression. Another important thing which we learned today is that the differential input voltage should be in the following range. If the differential input voltage is within this range, then we get some response, we get change in the output. If input differential input is beyond this range, then the outputs will not change and the device, you can say, is in cutoff, and this differential amplifier is not giving you any useful result. So the voltage gains for two modes, differential mode and single output voltage gain, both modes are given here. Voltage gain in case of differential mode is something like this, and voltage gain in case of single-ended configuration is given by this, right? You can see here transconductance is GM and here transconductance is GM by 2, right? Transconductances can also be compared in differential mode. Transconductance is simply GM of the device and it is given by this. In case of single-ended output, this single-ended output, this has indicated single-ended output, then transconductance will be half of the transconductance of MOS device, and it can also be expressed like this. So this transconductance we have seen in two different ways. So we have done this long calculation or more accurate calculation in order to find out the transconductances. So this is summary of everything which we have learned in this lecture. So with this, thank you very much.